Welcome to World Championship 2011 in Big Techno 2931 design class. Where are we? Well, the bridge behind me should answer a question for many.
Welcome to St. Francis Yacht Club.
St. Francis Yacht Club was established in 1927. It is one of the most prestigious yacht clubs in the world, and it has one of the most spectacular venues for the sailing in the world. You run big regattas almost every week, but it has been a long time since you had a world championship in windsurfing class.
Yeah, it has. I believe in 1991 was the last time we hosted a windsurfing world championship. San Francisco and the San Francisco Bay Area is just a fantastic place to be. It's a good place to live. I love it. It's a great place to visit. There are all kinds of things like Golden Gate Park on the other side of the city is one of the largest municipal parks in the country. There are all kinds of different things to do there. Beautiful museums, fantastic art collections. Hopefully sailors have planned some time before and after the event to enjoy a little bit of what the Bay Area has to offer. We're forecasting for great conditions this week. Typically San Francisco Bay gets 15 to 20 knots and even more just about every day. And even though the forecast was for rather light wind today, looking out on the bay right now, the breeze is fresh, see a little bit of white capping, and the sailors are going out for their first practice of the day, and we expect that it's just going to be a great event conditions-wise.
Do you know what time it is now?
I believe it's about 11:20.
No, it is time for action.
Time for action. You know it, baby. It's going to be awesome.
Yesterday we had registration and equipment inspection. 146 competitors from 26 countries are here competing in the 2011 championships. Race one is about to start.
It was a pretty big challenge for you to organize an event like this. Why did you decide to do it?
Well, first of all, I'm just one of the organizers. My contribution was probably bringing the event to San Francisco. It was time for the World Championships to get out of Europe and be the international class that it is, and it was time to come to this continent. So yeah, there were a lot of challenges because there are fewer sailors here and most of the sailors are coming from far away. We had to bring in 150 charter boards. And you know, that's a little complicated. Well, I think everyone I've talked to has said, this was a great venue. I mean, the beauty and the wind alone is worth coming here for. And then you have St. Francis Yacht Club, which is one of the best yacht clubs in the world for hosting a World Championships. And that combination, I think, well, everyone I've talked to says they're very happy to be here.
It's a beautiful venue here, but it's also a pretty challenging venue for the competitors. What do you think will be most difficult for the kids to handle around here?
Well, it certainly is intimidating. You know, there can be strong wind and big seas and a lot of boat traffic, and it's a big body of water and big ships going by. So it can be a little intimidating for kids, but once they get out there, you know, they're sailors and they can feel confident and gain more confidence through the days. And you see these little kids ripping out there, and it's just so cool to see.
What was the most difficult part of racing today?
I'd say just like staying in control and keeping the rig raked back upwind, and you know, just like going out there and kind of like...
Yeah, it was quite tough.
Yeah.
Because the wind got really strong.
Uh-huh.
And there was also the water was a little choppy.
I think wind, strong wind, and the wave, little wave, and
it's really difficult to sail in the top.
Yes, I like big waves.
What was the most difficult part of the day today?
The tide?
Yeah, dealing with the tide. It's pretty epic out there. And the start, getting off the start with the tide was pretty tricky.
The tide, yeah, starting in the tide, probably.
Yeah.
So how many attempts it took you to get to the top mark?
Just one. Just one. But lots of people.
Close to like the boy. Like.
At the windward mark I was going in, I had to tack twice because I missed the mark both times, and it was really frustrating. And you know, eventually I got it, but I lost a lot of ground.
The tide, definitely. There's a lot of tide here.
The current is very large, and the start is a bit difficult.
We'll be right back. cards. Each of the sailors, this is their fleet color. And to make sure we keep track of all 180 sailors, we want them to hang their placards here when they're out. So when they go out sailing, the different fleets, we have six different fleets. They hang their cards. When they come off the water, they take their card. It's kind of a way to keep inventory of the sailors that are out there. We don't want to lose any.
Kids are going out for another race, so let's explain the courses. We are looking right now on the windward leeward course on the western racing area here in San Francisco. After start between the committee boat and another small vessel, sailors go upwind to mark number one. After rounding a top mark, they head back towards the starting line, where they have to pass through the gate and go back upwind. Like any other sailing vessel, boards have to zigzag to top mark again. Then back down to the gate and short bridge to the finish.
Before the start, I like look for the wind, like how is the current, the water. I have like two plans. First, follow the one who's in first place, like Great Britain 6-2. But the second plan is to like look for the most windy parts, you know, and the less current, and then go always to that part.
Same question, you know, what is your game plan? You know, just before the start, what are you thinking about? Do you have a game plan?
Before the start, I first gonna think about my my upwind, if I go on daggerboard or fin, and which side of the lake I'm going to, the current, and I'm going to look for wind, and yeah, that's pretty much it.
Yesterday we spoke about the course. Today we're gonna concentrate on the most important part of it, start and the first upwind. Starting line is an imaginary line between two boats or a starting boat and a mark. Sailors are not allowed to cross it before the starting signal. In the light wind, they usually stay on the starting line and with the starting signal, they sail away. In the strong wind, as we see in the video, they approach the line in full speed and cross it with the starting signal. It is one of the most spectacular, but also one of the most important part of the race. Good start means that you have a clear wind, you are in front, and you do not have to worry about other sailors. But when you cross the line too soon, you have to sail around one of the starting line ends and start again to avoid disqualification. This is the case of New Zealand windsurfer, which is jibing around the pin end boat right now. Once you get out from the start, you sail upwind to mark number one. In planing conditions, which we had today, it does not take long for a fleet to spread around the course. This part of the race is hard to understand for most of the spectators.
In the light winds, you got the centerboard here and you just kick it down in the light winds.
Yeah.
And you have the track right at the front, and you need that to get upwind properly in the light when you're going slow. And you normally just chuck your front foot in here and just tip the rig back and just sit there and just keep it pointing high.
Pretty much. What is the difference then in the strong wind?
When it gets windy,